Okay, children. Again, I am here with yesterday's lesson, that is from Moment, our supplementary book, Moment, and lesson number 4, In the Kingdom of Fools. Yesterday, we have seen about the author and the short theme, the short summary of the recent lesson. Now, I will read this lesson. While reading, I will give you detailed explanation. So, here I start. In the Kingdom of Fools, it is believed that fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can manage them. Who are the fools in this story? What happens to them? In the Kingdom of Fools, both the king and the ministers were idiots. In the kingdom, always there are kingdom means who rules the king. Is a kingdom who rules king by king is called a kingdom, and of course the ministers, both were means all were idiots. They were fool. They didn't want to run things like other kings, so they decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night, till their fields and run their business only after dark. They had decided night would be day and day would be night, and all night they will work, and early in the morning in the daytime they will sleep. That was the decision from king. And everybody, they have to do, the people of the kingdom, they have to follow that. So that started from that day. And anyone who disobeyed would be punished. Death. It was order. Those who did disobey, even the animals, goats, they were also obeying all this order. Then the people did as they were told for fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. They were all the ministers and they were very happy. One day, a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Everyone was asleep. Not a mouse stirring. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening. When suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. When they entered, this guru and wise guru and his disciple, then they saw that all were sleeping. They were very hungry, and at evening time they saw that all people woke up and doing their nightly work as king order. The two men grow hungry. Who are these two men? Of course, Guru and Disciple. Now that the shops were open, they went to buy some groceries. To their astonishment, they found that everything cost the same, a single doo-doo. When they went to the grocery shop, you know, they found that all the cost, all the things cost is one doo-doo. It's one type of currency. That is a very small amount, cheap amount, you know, the like 1 rupee and 50 paisa in that way. One to do. Whether they bought a measure of rice or a bunch of bananas. If they want to rice also in 1 to 2, bananas also 1 to 2, everything in 1 to 2. They have never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. In 1 rupee they could have brought everything. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools. Guru realized, because guru was very clever. Guru was has a wisdom, you know, fools, and it wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. This is no place for us. Let's go, he said. Guru said, this is fools. People are staying there. We will not say, if we will remain over here, it will be problematic for us only. Now we will leave the place. was good, cheap wood, the guru said. They are all fools. This won't last every very long. And you can't pay what they do to you next, because you don't, we will not stay here. We will go tomorrow. What will happen with us for living with these fool people? Don't know, so we will leave. But the disciple didn't listen to the guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay there only. The guru finally gave up and said, "Do what you want. I'm going." And he left that kingdom. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and peas and rice and wheat, and grew like a plant, like a street side sacred bowl. Khaki wo disciple jo katla sa tha, kafi kya ho gaya wo, mota ho gaya, because everything was getting it. What to do? See, every day I'm eating, sleeping. Then he got a, you know, fat like a street sign, sacred bowl. One bright day, then the critical condition starts of this disciple. One bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. And as he was carrying out his loot, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. That one thief, he broke the king's wall and went inside to loot something. And as he was coming out, the big wall fell on him and killed him on the spot. His brother ran to the king and complained, "Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing me, doing something, our old ancient worker, pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have been a good strong wall. He should have been a strong wall. Why he been a very weak wall? And because of weak wall, my brother died there. This merchant is to blame. He punished the wrongdoer and compensated the family for this injustice." The king said, "Justice will be done. Don't worry." And at once summoned the owner of the house. He said to their brother, "Don't worry, you will get justice. Call all of that merchant in the kingdom, in the palace, in the courtyard." When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him, "What's your name?" "Such and such," he said. "My name is this and this." "Your Highness, were you at home when dead man burgled your house?" "Yes, my lord. He broke in and the wall was weak. It fell on him." "You have murdered a man," king said to merchant. "We have to punish you." "Lord," said the helpless merchant, "aren't you then put up the wall? It's really the fault of man who beat the wall." "You made it for the king. Those who beat the wall, it's his fault. It is not my fault. He didn't take it right. You should punish him." "Who is that?" "My lord, this wall was made in my father's time. I know the man. He's an old man now. Old man now. He lives nearby." "You see, daddy is the one in your father's time. So now he's old. So king order, call him." And the king sent our messengers to bring in the bricklayer who had built the wall. They brought him. The wall? Bricklayer in the court. Or brought him, tied hand and foot. "You there? Did you build this man's wall in his father's time?" "Yes, my lord, I did." "What kind of wall is this that you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. you have to punish your partner. You paid that cow, so you must get punishment. Before the king could order the execution, the poor bricklayer pleaded. He said that, bricklayer said that, please listen to me before you give your order, before you give me punishment. You just listen to what I'm saying. It's true. It's true. I built this wall and it was no good. I know that. I built that wall and the quality was not good. But that was because my mind was not on it. He's saying that. I built. But when I was building that wall, my mind was not on it. I remember very well a dancing girl who was going up and down that street all day with her anklets jingling, you know, jingling anklets. You see, power, we don't jump up, because of that, I was distracted. My mind was distracted with her anklets jingling. I couldn't keep my eyes on my mind on the wall I was building. You must get that dancing girl. I know where she lives. Majesty, Highness, this was not my fault, not mine. Now that is that dancing girl's fault. Because of her jingling and anklets, I was distracted, I couldn't pay attention, and it was a weak wall. You are right. The case depends. We must look into it. It is not easy to judge such a complicated cases. Let's get that dancer. Wherever she is, the order, king order, wherever she is now, pray. Now, what happened here, children? That day, let's now this great player was also old man, and that time, this dancing girl was now she became an old woman. The dancing girl now had old woman. Came trembling to the court, that they were not scared, and came into the court. Did you walk up and down, up and down? That street many years ago? Why this poor man building a wall? Did you see him? Yes, my lord. I remember it very well. She agreed. Yes, I remember it very well. So, you did walk up and down with your anklet jingling. You were young and you distracted me. So, he built a bad wall because of you. He beat a bad wall. It has fallen on a poor butler and killed him. You have killed an innocent man. He said to that dancing girl, you will have to be punished. She thought for a moment. She thought something and said, what she said? My lord, wait. I know. Now, why I was walking up and down, she remembered. Now she said, why I was going up and down? Oh, Anajana Kaveri, why I was going up and down on that street? I had given some coal to Godfrey to make some jewelry for me. And he was lazy spotter. He made so many excuses. Say he would keep it now and he would give it then and so on all day. I had given my jewelry to make jewelry for me to that girl's maid, and he didn't keep the promise, and he was telling you come now then, and afterward the whole day I was doing up and down to the right girl's maid. Because of that, I didn't give them so on all day. He made me walk up and down to his house for a dozen times. Give me about a dozen times. That was when this bricklayer saw me. When I was doing up and down, then bricklayer saw me. It's not my fault, my lord. It's the big man. Damn Goldsmith's fault. This is not my fault. That is Damn Goldsmith's fault. corner of his shop. When he heard the accusation, that's a claim, accusation against him, he had his own story to tell. Now, whose turn? Goldsmith's turn. My lord, he said, I am a poor goldsmith. It's true, I made this dancer come many times to my door. I gave her excuses because I couldn't finish making her jewelry before I finished the rich merchant's order. Whose rich was then again this goldsmith has come? He said, yes, I couldn't keep her promise because I got an order from merchant's house and it was very important, so I was busy to make that jewelry. Orders, they had a wedding in that merchant's house, they had a wedding, so I was busy doing that jewelry coming and they wouldn't wait. You know how impatient rich men are. Rich men are always impatient. They want all the things earlier. Who is this rich merchant who kept you from finishing this poor woman's jewelry? Who is that rich man? Then many a walk up and down, which distracted this great mayor, which made a mess of his wall, which has now fallen on an innocent man and killed him. Can you name him? The goldsmith named the merchant, and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen down. You know the story. Yesterday we have seen, first was the merchant. After the merchant who was there, the bricklayer was there. After the bricklayer who was there, the dancing girl was there. After the dancing girl who was there, the goldsmith was there, you know. And after the goldsmith, what he said? He said that it was not my fault. See, it was coming here, then here, then here, and then goldsmith said, no, it's not my fault. This fault is again whose fault? This merchant's fault. The same merchant's fault, you know. That merchant's fault. The goldsmith named the merchant and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall was fallen. Now justice had come full circle. See, the full circle started from your work, then again it went again to merchant. This is a complete full circle. Thought the king back to the merchant. When
merchant was very thin. This merchant was very thin. So that stay was not completely fit for that merchant. He appealed to the king's common sense. The king too worried about it. What shall we do now? Now that stay is not perfect for this merchant to whom we have to give punishment. So that is not perfect. What shall we do? He said. When suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was a fine of fat enough to fit the stake. Now he is a thing. He cannot fit there. So go search in the kingdom of that person and ask him to come and we will give him punishment. Then the servant went immediately sent all over the town looking for a man who would fit the stake. And their eyes fell on the disciple who had fattened himself for months on bananas and rice and wheat and wheat. You know the disciple was thin. Taking one from one to two, was eating every day, sleeping and become fat. Then the ministers observed that man, the disciple, he brought that disciple here. We have done what I have done wrong. I am innocent. I am sannyasi. Like what a disciple is saying. He cried, what may be true? But it's the royal degree, royal. This king's order that we have to bring to you to in the palace. That we should find a man fat enough to fit the state. They said, I'm carrying him. This is a city of fools. You don't know what they will do next. While he was waiting for that, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his cry wherever he was. He remembered his guru's sentence. Now we will not remain here. We will go from here and but he did not listen that. Who had dug himself into such a scrap to love of food. He was very crazy to eat the food. As soon as he arrived, he scolded the disciple and told him something in a whisper. Then he went to the king and addressing. Oh, wisest of kings, who is greater, the guru or disciple? You know, guru was very, guru had a magical power and he had come there and they were there. Then as soon as he arrived, the guru arrived in the court, he scolded the disciple and told him something in a whisper, very small, barring a basin. Then he went to the king and addressed him. O wisest of kings, who is greater, the guru or the disciple? Of course the guru, no doubt about it. Why do you ask? Then put me to the stake for see the guru. Very wise, he took that king aside and whispered something in his ear and said, who is the greatest, the guru or the disciple? Then king said, of course, guru. Who is a great personality? Then put me in the stake first. Then who said? This wise man said. Then guru said, no, don't give him punishment. Give me punishment. Then put my disciple there after me. My disciple is after in the give that way. When the disciple heard this, he understood and began to claim, or make the noise. Me to him. Do you know why he wants to die right now? The two offers. Why he wanted to die? He asked, why you want to die? When the fat man is there, then he said, I will tell you. But will you listen to me now? After that also, he just gave me punishment. We have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. That state is the state of God of justice. And it's new. It has never had a criminal or him. Whoever dies on the first, on it first, will be reborn as the king of this country. Those who will first die on that state will be the next king, and the second, those who will now be the minister of that king. The king state of good to God justice. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whoever dies in on the first will be the reborn as the king of the country, and whoever goes next will be the future minister of this country. And whoever goes next will be the future minister of the country. We are sick of our ascetic, you know, ascetic life. It would be, that is, ascetic life is a sannyasi life. We are bored with that. So we want to now become a king and a minister. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as a king and minister of our life. Now, keep your word, my Lord, and put us to death. Me first. Remember, the king was now thrown into deep thought. So, he didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. He needed time. So, he ordered the execution postponed. Tomorrow, postponed to the next day, and talk in secret with his minister. It's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on the stage ourselves, and we will be reborn as a king and a minister again. We will die. We will not give the punishment. We will go on the stage. So he told the executioners, we will send the criminals tonight. Well, the first man come to you, put him to the death first, then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. Then he gave order to the people. Now, they will come to you, and first those will come, give them, and second, give them the second. Those who are coming first and second, don't see anything behind them. Just follow my order. That night, the king and the minister went secretly to the prison. No. This happened to be in the prison. But secretly, this king and kingdom, unko bahar nikalke, wo raja or wo minister under unki jagah pe gaye, and they have released the disciple and guru out, and they were inside too, and arranged beforehand with the royal servants. Were taken to the stake and promptly executed. When the bodies were taken down to the after the death, they always do, they use, you know,